Hi everyone, the Discussionizer is back, and in this episode I'm gonna talk about green energy. Let's see what we can do. Save the planet for me and you. You may have noticed that it's been a while since my last video. The reason is very simple. I've been feeling extremely demotivated and somehow I lost my interest in doing basically anything. This COVID seems to be breaking me down. It's difficult to admit, but apparently I'm not too motivated right now, which is pretty much the opposite of what I am usually. But I managed to pull my shit together so I can deliver you a nice video. In this episode, it's gonna be about green energy. I don't know if you noticed, but most electricity companies are delivering green energy. And it's just so green that I thought these countries must be producing 80%, 90% green electricity. However, as it turns out, of course, it's not true. So most companies are lying and they are not correct on their statements. I also share an article about this, so you will see it somewhere here or here. The Netherlands produces only 16% of its electricity from green sources. So explain me how it's possible that most of these companies selling their electricity as green. The other funny thing is why NS, the Dutch train company, is running on full green electricity, and it turns out that the electricity, they don't actually buy it from the Netherlands, they buy it from other countries because the Netherlands don't produce enough green electricity. Don't you find it funny that the Netherlands has its image that it's so green and so nice, while in reality the electricity, as I mentioned before, only 16% generated from renewable or green sources, and the total energy consumption, not only electricity but other usage as well, it's only 7 to 8%. That is one of the worst in the whole European Union. So currently generating electricity or energy fully from renewables, it's impossible. In some countries they are relatively close to it, but they are blessed with lots of hydroelectricity, so they can use it as a baseline production. In other countries, it's just not possible. Periodically, you might get lots of electricity from wind or solar, but that's not a solution for long term. What else can you do? First of all, what you can do is to change your lifestyle. Secondly, you come up with a new scientific breakthrough that can generate electricity in a green way. Or third, nuclear. Now I'm going to talk about why nuclear is good. First of all, it's green. Lots of people don't think about that, but it doesn't actually generate CO2. You have relatively cheap and clean energy source available as a baseline production. Second, it's energy dense. So the fuel that we use in nuclear power plants are extremely energy dense. So imagine this little nuclear pellet that you can see in this video. If you put a bunch of together in the size of a Rubik cube, then that would be enough for the energy consumption of your entire life. For one person's entire life, that Rubik cube size of nuclear fuel is enough. Third, well-established science. Now, of course, you can debate about that, given there were some nuclear disasters, but most of those were overcome, and also they were the results of other factors. So this science really works, and it's awesome. So the fourth, there is very little nuclear waste. That is, again, not what people think about. Given that it's very energy dense, that we already covered, the end result, the waste, is also very little. So in this picture, you can see the total nuclear waste that had been produced in Switzerland can fit in this room. And 30 to 35% of their electricity is coming from nuclear. So you can imagine how little waste it generates. Now, in another picture that you can see right now, that is the nuclear waste of the United States since they running nuclear power plants. That is from 1960 or something. So in the last 60 years, the total nuclear waste can fit in a football field stacked up to few meters high. Also, they handle it very well. They dig deep holes, they nicely seal it off, and there is absolutely no way that it can contaminate the environment. The fifth one, almost negligible death coming from nuclear compared to other sources, for example, fossil. When we talk about nuclear, people usually think about huge disasters, and they see all everywhere these mushroom clouds around them.
Hey, look, that one looks like a giraffe.
Huh, that one looks like a mushroom.
However, that is not what reality is. Even the biggest disasters, Fukushima and Chernobyl, didn't result in as many deaths as most people think they did. For example, Chernobyl only created 4 to 60,000 deaths. Now, the spread seems pretty large. 4 is coming from the United Nations estimate. 60,000 is coming from the European Green Party, and they usually blow everything out of proportions. Of course, we can say it's big number, but that was the only thing that actually happened once in the history of humanity. And what's important is that even from this huge disaster, a relatively small number of people died. I don't want to downplay a nuclear disaster, but when it comes to Chernobyl, life came back to relatively normal. I went there in 2019, and you can actually see that it's relatively okay.
So here we are in Pripyat. Radiation level is getting higher, but not too bad.
Now, the other big accident that most people can recall is Fukushima. How many people died in Fukushima relating to this nuclear disaster? 573. And this 573 didn't actually die from radiation or mushroom clouds, as of course lots of people imagine. They died in the stress of the evacuation. In reality, these numbers look like a lot because they are related to one particular event that happens all of a sudden. However, if you compare it to how many people died because of air pollution and other environmental factors that happens due to fossil fuel burning, then you get to a way larger number. So yearly, it is estimated that 4 million people dies related to burning fossil fuels. If you add up in the last 50 years, that goes to 100 million people. Of course, if you consider that we also burning fossil fuel a lot more to generate electricity than nuclear, for example, then this comparison is not entirely fair. But if you check it per energy unit generated, in that case, let's use 1 terawatt hour, then you also get an overwhelmingly larger number for burning fossil fuels. For 1 terawatt hour generation, for 50 years, fossil fuel goes to a death toll of 1,200 people, while nuclear is only 3.5. And that includes direct and indirect effects. So why don't we use the nuclear too much? It is because of the public opinion. The public opinion is so bad about that, that governments don't even dare to touch the topic. The problem with that is that the people who are the loudest about this topic know the least about nuclear power generation. Effectively, they are probably so stupid that they don't even know how to solve their kids' homework, but they are really going demonstrating everywhere to go against nuclear power plants. But in fact, I guess these are the same people who go to not vaccinate their kids or turn down 5G antennas because they are damaging their brain. So these people seem to be so successful that in countries like Japan and Germany, they are dismantling nuclear power plants. And you know what? Can you guess what they're replacing them with? Fossil fuel. So that's so awesome. Thanks to Greenpeace. Thanks everyone. So I think you're a smart person because you made it that long in my video. If you were stupid, you would have clicked away long time ago. So I'm really curious about your opinion because I like smart people's opinion, even if it's challenging mine. So please leave it in the comment section or tell me or any other way you like it. But I'm curious what you think about nuclear power generation, seeing all the facts and details that I just given to you. So see you later, and that was it for this episode. Bye guys.